Anthony Santos and Mayimbe, you know, means a lot to me for many reasons, you know. He influenced me in many ways, you know, and I first heard about him, you know, my father brought a cassette. There wasn't DVDs back in the days, you know, and he brought a cassette. And it all started like a joke, you know. It was like, listen, this guy has your name, you know, and I'm like, well, I have his name because he's obviously, you know, older than me. And I didn't know what it was about. I knew it was a bachata artist, but I didn't think anything, you know, of the cover. I was just like, oh, you know, one day, you know, I just popped on the CD, the cassette. And I just fell in love with the music, you know, and from that point on, I just became a fan. The tape he brought was actually his third production. He had two previous, you know, albums out. And I immediately went to purchase, you know, the first two, and I became a fan. And you know, I even went to see him in a presentation he had in New York City. I stepped to him, you know, and I was like, listen, I have your name. I showed him my ID. He was extremely nice to me, you know, and he's been like a mentor, you know, to me. You know, it's kind of like interesting because we develop a great friendship, relationship that I call him like my artistic father, and I say bendición, and he tells me Dios te bendiga, which is kind of like, I don't know how to describe that in English. It's like when you tell someone. I don't even know how do you say that in English? It's like a blessing, like, oh, you know, like, go on, my son,